So they are assaulting this bus driver as we speak right now.
A school bus assault caught on video 6 months ago. Three junior high school students beat up their driver.
They're juveniles, they're under the age of 17, and there are all consequences for these type of actions.
But Fox 4 News found out there's no criminal case yet. So what happened?
A prosecutor will look at this and go, this needs to go a step further.
The news leader, broadcasting for all North Texas. Fox 4 News starts now.
That school bus attack is a story you will see only on Fox 4. Good evening, I'm Therese Tinsley.
I'm Steve Eager, it's 9 o'clock. This video of a bus driver being punched and eventually kicked is disturbing enough, but also concerning. Fox 4 News has learned there was never a criminal investigation into this attack, which happened in February. That seems to have changed after Fox 4's James Rowe started asking questions late today. James in now with the exclusive details.
Well, Stephen, Clarice, the bus is owned and operated by Dallas County Schools, a transportation organization which provides buses and drivers for many area school districts. This video is from cameras on board the bus and was leaked to us by a source who was upset that there was no criminal investigation into the attack of an elderly bus driver by young teens. Since the students are juveniles, we've blurred their faces.
February 12th, a bus driver from Dallas County Schools is on his route carrying Richardson Independent School District students to Forest Meadow Junior High School in Lake Highlands. At one point, the bus driver pulls over after one of the students throws a Dr. Pepper bottle towards the bus driver, hitting the windshield. Then the driver stops the bus. He gets up and stands in the aisle. There's no clear audio, but words are exchanged between the driver and some of the students. The audio and video is from an onboard camera, and it's distorted. We can't hear exactly what's being said. The driver picks up his two-way radio and appears to be alerting a dispatcher or a supervisor about what's going on. Seconds later, several students head toward the driver. The driver and one student exchange pushes, then that student starts throwing punches, and so does some other students. In the melee, the driver swings once and misses. As he's falling back out the bus doors, several students continue the attack, knocking and punching him through the doors of the bus and onto the ground. Other students get off the bus, jockeying for position to try and get a good view of the violent attack. The concerned citizen who brought this to our attention wondered why there was no criminal investigation.
I was disturbed. I was shocked that we now have videos of middle schoolers that are attacking a bus driver as they're driving down the road, throwing things.
Criminal defense attorney, reserve sheriff deputy, and former prosecutor Pete Schulte did not represent anyone in this case, but saw the video and offered his opinion.
Obviously, we need to know more details about what exactly took place before the altercation, but there's clearly an assault there.
Richardson ISD says three students were suspended after they learned of the attack, but since the driver is an employee of the transportation company and not the district, Richardson ISD is not responsible for initiating a criminal investigation. Fox 4 went to Dallas County Schools and started asking questions. The organization's police chief, Scott Peters, says he was unaware of the video, saying it was never brought to his attention, but will begin an investigation immediately.
The bus driver is the adult in charge. He's a middle schooler. They have to listen to the authority figures on that bus. And when they don't, and they start throwing punches, that's a crime.
Now, Steve, you know, this is a troubling story, but I spoke by phone with Chief Peters, who says it is clear someone dropped the ball on this case, and he says the driver appeared to follow protocol because what that called for would have been for him to pick up the microphone, call dispatch. Dispatch would then send Dallas County Schools police officers to assist the driver and, if deemed necessary, arrest the teens who assaulted the elderly driver. That did not happen here, and the chief says he plans to find out exactly why. But another thing to keep in mind, this was a Dallas County Schools employee. So that's, you know, another reason.
Let's talk about this. They have buses. I don't know that this one did, but I'm assuming Dallas County put a lot of these in effect. There's like an alert button they call. You can have your audio. They record this stuff. So what's the point?
Well, you know, these buses have some of the most sophisticated monitoring equipment on buses and police anywhere in America. So You know, that's one of the biggest problems that everybody's trying to understand is how could something like this have happened and no one know about it?
Tapes not reviewed generally?
Well, you can't review all the tapes, but if you have a complaint and a bus number and a driver, you know what bus and driver to go to review the tape. And the chief tells me the first time he heard about this was when I contacted his department earlier today, you know, which was closed. They're gearing up for school, but they were able to reach out to him, get him, and I did speak with him on the phone. And, you know, the whole goal in outfitting these buses with panic buttons and live feed cameras was to ensure that students and drivers are safe. And if there's an incident, the command center could immediately put eyes on the situation and handle it.
I have a feeling they'll be doing this over the weekend, next week, and we'll start.